Who would do that in the toilet, right? With the smell and everything. Hi, I'm Fuquan from CNB, and this is Ask CNB Anything. Simply put, you know, CNB officers, we keep Singapore drug-free. We do preparation for operations. We solicit intelligence. We conduct, you know, supervision on reporting supervisees, specifically those urine reporting, and we even conduct preventive drug education in schools. That's, you know, our day-to-day life. The garang training, which I'll typically refers to firearm training. We do surveillance training as well. So these are the garang components. So the softer side of us, the softer training that we do, learning how to give talks to, you know, different groups of people, primary school kids, secondary school kids, how we engage them in the preventive drug education. So these are the different, you know, all-rounded kind of training that CNB officers undergo. It is definitely tough, it's definitely challenging, but the most important part is it's very fulfilling, because what we are doing, we are actually helping the next generation. We are preventing, you know, the drug harmful effects from reaching out to the next generation. I think that is the most fulfilling part of our job. It may look easy, but actually there's a lot of work to be done back end. Typically before conducting an operation, we will conduct a recce. We'll take a look at the operating terrain, plan our ingress, egress routes. We also conduct in-depth surveillance on our subject. We typically know what is their operating hours like, what is their modus operandi. So in short, it's kind of like doing our homework before we go to exam so that we can ace it. Longest operations will be around 2 to about 3 days. Typically, it will be the manhunt type of operation because, yeah, you're looking for one human is essentially, you know, looking for a needle in a haystack. They can get pretty aggressive. Could be holding a weapon and then, you know, swinging against us, telling us, you know, back off, don't try to, you know, come and arrest me. If not, I'll either kill myself or I'll kill you. And how do we handle? First of all, of course, we try to de-escalate the situation. We will try to talk to him, calm him down and stuff like that. So if that doesn't work, then we might have to resort to using necessary force. Yeah. Okay, usually we use force only when necessary. So for example, if a subject is uncompliant, if they are aggressive and actively, you know, trying to escape, trying to deter us from doing our job, trying to resist arrest, then we will use the necessary force required to actually apprehend him. All operations, we will definitely carry guns. But of course, whether we use it or not really depends on the situation that we are in. While, you know, we're doing our job using our force and everything, we are mindful of the safety of the member of public, our officers, and also the subject himself. I remember one incident where we were just about to raid a particular unit for drug trafficking offense. When we approached the unit, it just so happened that the owner came back, and then the owner was pushing a pram with a baby inside. Upon seeing us, it's kind of like a cat and mouse thing. They can smell us from afar, and we can smell them from even further. So once they see us, they kind of just push the pram to us, and then the couple just ran in separate direction. So the baby is actually with us. Yeah, we end up taking care of the baby, and then different parties, you know, we split and we actually got them. Pretty much anywhere under the sun, you know, I would say away from the sun. They typically do their drug activities, you know, at night and stuff like that. So the most bizarre place, you know, a transaction happened is inside the toilet. Who would do that in the toilet, right? With the smell and everything, but well, drug traffickers. Well, I not only watch the show, I'm actually part of the committee making the show. I would say it's as close to realism as possible. We modeled the story after real life cases that have concluded years back. Even the firearms that we use in the show, they are real. They are real firearms. Well, it's already exposed, isn't it? No, but you know, in all seriousness, we're not so concerned about our identities being exposed, so long as op secrecy is actually maintained. Well, tell your mother you're doing something good. You are doing a fulfilling job. You are, you know, preventing the next generation from exposing themselves to the harms of drugs. So, yeah, it's exciting. I guarantee you it's nothing that you will see from a dead small job. If you have any questions about joining CNB, feel free to check out the link below.